Beth is my favorite song, not only because it's how Peter feels about me, but how every man feels when he's away from the woman he loves. KISS is performing tonight, and they just want me to thank everyone for this great honor, and I want to personally thank KISS. I love you.
I should just mention that accepting for Beth was the Beth for whom the song was written, the wife of the drummer, Mrs. Peter Criss.
Hi, happy 21st birthday, Criss.
Hi there. What's up, guys? We're hanging out at the Indianapolis KISS convention, and we are with Peter Criss's ex-wife, Lydia Criss. How are you enjoying this convention?
I'm having a ball. You know, I'm sorry it's winding down. It's getting towards the end.
It is. It's sad. It's so sad. Everyone's leaving, and oh, it's all packed down. I saw so much KISS this weekend, and it's all over. I'm so upset.
Yesterday was amazing.
It was awesome. And you're still part of the KISS world. How does it feel to still be a appreciated here?
Well, I'm actually shocked. I'm shocked at how many people love my book, how many people tell me, you know, how they appreciate, they thank me, that, you know, they're glad I'm here. I mean, I'm just overwhelmed.
Hey, I think all of us fans here are got that overwhelmed feeling. This is the 20th anniversary of this expo, and there was just so much going on. So much. I mean, Creeley's Comet reunited for this. What an event. So you actually wrote a book called Sealed with a Kiss, correct?
Yes.
Could you talk about what that kind of is about?
Well, it's about my life, very little about the beginning of my life, and then when I first met Peter. And then there's the bigger part of the book is with KISS. And then there's after KISS. So it's before KISS, during KISS, and after KISS. And after KISS is like my story, my life in my photography business, you know, where I photographed every rock star, you know, you can think of Mick Jagger, David Bowie, Queen, Rod Stewart. I mean, I can keep going on. Elton John, Billy Joel, Cheap Trick, Van Halen.
That is awesome.
Just goes on and on and on. Yeah. I mean, I just love that part of my life too. You know, when I got divorced from Peter, I had to figure out something to do with myself. So I said, I knew I was separated, so I knew I was getting divorced, and I decided to take a course in photography. Even though I did know how to take pictures because my family is a bad picture family. Like my uncle was a photographer. My mother always had a camera.
I just want to say hi. You and I'm Scott Armstrong. You and I chatted at in New York a couple years ago at Christmas.
We're doing an interview.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's all good.
It's all right. Yeah, it's all right.
It happens to me all the time. I'm a Warped Tour interview and people walk through stuff all the time.
Yeah. I don't remember him, but, you know, whatever. I meet so many people. So I decided to take a course in photography, and that's what I went to a KISS event, believe it or not, at Studio 54, and I brought some of my Rod Stewart photos with me because I had 13th row seats, and I had, you know, my zoom lens, and I actually ran up to like a third row and stood on somebody's seat because everybody was standing. So I stood on, and I took great photos of him. It was like the first time I had ever like, wow, these are really good. So I brought them to me to this KISS thing. I brought them with me to this KISS thing, and I saw Bob Corwin, who was the photographer that did the Dress to Kill album cover, and he was still a friend of mine, and he also did the John Lennon New York City T-shirt.
I know which one you're talking about.
Yeah. And he's still a friend of mine to this day. And anyway, so then I asked him, I said, what should I do with these photos? I want to get them, you know, in magazines. So he goes, this, go to Virginia. I said, where's Virginia? He goes, you know, she's starting a photo agency. So he reintroduced me to Virginia, which I did know her. But he reintroduced me to her, and I started working for her. I worked for 16 years. Friends. Employee, and I also did her books. I was her photographer, her friend, and her bookkeeper.
That is one story.
Yeah.
And it looks like you got some photos here that are pretty cool.
Well, this is the Bob Gruen, and this is the Bob Gruen. He came to Japan with
us. Oh, these are from the Japanese tour, huh?
Yes, yes.
And you got to be a part of that phenomenal tour. That was 1977, correct?
I went to both, 78 too.
Oh, yeah. Wow. What is one thing you loved about Japan?
I think it was the way they treated everybody like gods. I mean, they are so polite. And just seeing the other side of the world and the culture and the way people live, you know, like it's a whole different thing. And the way they cherish their temples and that, all that. I mean, and of course the food is phenomenal, so, you know.
Of course.
And we ate the best.
Hey, that's what it's about. All right, KISS fans, you've heard it from Lydia Criss here at the 20th KISS Expo in Indianapolis. Be sure to check out her book release, Sealed with a Kiss.
Bye-bye.
Well, you've never seen a KISS like this one. KISS is the name of a group. Four unbelievable young musical performers whose albums and concert appearances have really been creating a musical revolution. They're playing in Chicago tonight, unfortunately, but they did want you to see them in action. So they filmed the concert performance of the song you young people out there chose as the top song of 1976. So here they are singing their hit song, Beth, the incredible KISS. The young people's favorite new song. Well, how does one describe a pixie, an elf, a comic sprite, a kind of a melodious, mellifluous marvel of mirth, a miracle of magical merriment? Well, only one way. Just speak her name, ladies and gentlemen, Goldie Hawn.
Music. It's a reflection of the times we live in. Today's music is frenetic and dissonant and cacophonous, which sums it up for me perfectly. I don't know what those words mean, and I don't know what's going on in the world either. But I do know that I can... songs we heard here tonight. Muskrats and ducks are my favorite animals, and I once knew a girl named Beth at camp. The songs you young people, oh, is this for the young people? Chose as your favorites are Disco Duck, Muskrat Love, and Beth. And the winner is, oh boy, it's a tie. I have to read the first one first. Congratulations, Beth!
Now we won the award for the best singer of 1976.
Honestly, Beth is my favorite song. Not only because it's how Peter feels about me, but how every man feels when he's away from the woman he loves. KISS is performing tonight, and they just want me to thank everyone for this great honor, and I want to personally thank KISS. I love you.
I should just mention that accepting for Beth was the Beth for whom the song was written, the wife of the drummer, Mrs. Peter Criss.